this past week. Monday was Halloween, right? I hope you had a good Halloween, right? Well, Halloween is the day before a special day in the church, and it's called All Saints' Day. And what does that mean? All Saints' Day is where we recognize all the people of the past who have died in the Lord that are Christian. That could be your, maybe you have a grandfather or grandmother that died, but maybe your great-grandparents is in that number, your great-great-great-grandparents, all the way back. All those believers. And we give thanks to God that they are now with Jesus in heaven. So I was looking for a special something to say about All Saints Day. And this brings up another matter. You know, we have devotionals out there, portals of prayer for for mostly adults, but and we also pass out little devotion slips there. But there are devotion books for children too, and when our boys were young, we used to get this My Devotions, and they still print this. This would be a good thing for you, for your parents to buy, and it's every day they have a different devotion, and it's at your level. It's for children, but it's also for adults too. And so I think it's $14 a year now. Every day you have a devotion. So this is an old one that I still have. It's from November 1990. And so they have this devotion about All Saints Day. And this is something, well, I guess I did read it all those years back, but I did not remember this, and I don't know this. But it's called Saint or Sinner. So I'm going to read you part of it. So this is new to me, too. Children in England used to play a game called Saints and Sinners. You see this boy? He has a bow and arrow. See? And a hoop, like a circle, was set up at a measured distance, and the players were each given 10 arrows. The object was to shoot the arrows through the hoop. If anyone shot all the arrows through, he was called a saint. But if he missed just one, he was named a sinner. If he missed with all 10 arrows, he was not a greater sinner than if he missed only one. One error was as bad as 10. That was the rule of the game, even though it sounded unfair. And then this goes on to say about sin. And sin is missing the mark, like kind of shoot the arrow through the hoop. You missed the mark. That's sin, we missed the mark. And God's rules say we have to be perfect. And so the rules of God also apply to our Savior Jesus. And it says here, the rules apply to his son, whom he sent in the world, Jesus of Nazareth, our brother. But Jesus never missed the mark. And he did this because of us. Now, okay, what would you say a saint is? What is a saint? And, or, yeah?
A Christian.
That's the best term to say what the saint is. Is a Christian perfect?
No.
No. And that's one thing that this game is wrong, is that it kind of says that if you make, you know, if you miss the mark by an arrow not going through the hoop, you're not a saint. That's not true, because if we're sinners, but we're Christians, we are also saints. So that means you believe. question. That's our job, to tell them about Jesus. And I told you in the past messages that you are missionaries. And you are to go out and tell your friends, your playmates, about Jesus. And I said that Jesus called you the salt of the earth. And now you know, if you didn't know before, you are saints. Isn't that something? That's great. And so let me read this closing prayer psalm here, because it's very good. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for keeping the law perfectly for me. You also died in order to remove all my sins. It's so wonderful to know that I am now a forgiven saint because of you. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor.
Hold it this way.